Today we're going to take a look at OcenAudio and how to record a voiceover inside of that. If you're on a Mac, head on up to the OcenAudio list there and go to Preferences. If you're on a PC, it's probably File and System Preferences or something to that effect. I'm not a Windows guy, so I'm going to go to Preferences over here. All right, so let's head over to the Sound tab. There it is. And this is where you're going to select your input and output devices. So your playback device, so you can hear what you've recorded. In my case, I'm using an external mixer, which uses the USB audio codec. And if your case, if you can see your external device there that you're using, or just go to system default, and that should probably come out whatever your system is set up for playback of audio already. Now to record the input device, same thing again, just have a look if you can see your microphone, if it's a USB microphone or whatever it is that you're using. See if you can pull that up in that list and select that one. In my case, again, it's the same mixer, it's the USB mixer. All done and dusted. Okay, so head to the record button and this will set up our audio. So what we need to do here is we'll set up 44,100 cycles. So that's the same as CD quality, no problem there. And because we're only recording in one microphone, mono is perfect. Okay, and we'll select 24 bits because primarily that will give us a little bit of extra room regardless of the level that's coming in for later on in post-production. So hit OK and we'll be off to the races. So now you can see my voice in the screen here. So that's live and it's recording that. So I can do my voiceover. The mix! It's what you want. And then I can push the stop button. Now I can actually push this button over here, this little magnifying glass, to go to one, and it'll take me zoom right out to everything. Okay, and over here, if I just click that button there, right there, and go play, make that available, here we go. It's what you want. Okay, so I want that bit there because I know that's what I record, the mix, what you want. And then I'll just hit that little button here. It says trim, so it'll get rid of everything else except what we've selected and highlighted there. Boom. The mix, it's what you want. There we go, nice and easy. Now over here, I'm just gonna right click on this and go save as. And up in here, go what you want with a funny old U or zero there, O, whatever. And just from the format, so we don't want to compress this at all. We want to leave it as pristine as we can. In this case, we'll just go down the list and select Wave PCM Linear, and that will be just fine. So you hit the save button and it's done. Now if you want to do another one, in this case we'll go up here to the next menu and we'll go File in my place and go New, and that'll start us again with a new one, same scenario. And off we go again. Okay, so once we hit the record button. The mix. Were you here last Friday? Miss a week? Miss a lot. Same thing again. So hit the plus button on the one. The mix. There we go. And select, trim, easy, and then save as over here. Same thing again, make sure it's Wave. Miss a week. And then save it. Easy. And that's all you need to do. So just make sure that nothing up here is going distorted or clipping or square. Otherwise, whatever input that you've got, try and just bring that back a little bit. And you'll find that it won't distort when you play it back. And that's the key thing, is capturing a nice clean audio. The mix. Were you here last Friday? There we go. Hopefully that helps. Talk to you soon. Cheers.